Hi, welcome to this video about the AdSense Management API. I'm Jose Alterica, and I'm here with Nick Johnson.
Hi, I am a machine that turns coffee into code, and I write the AdSense app for iPhone here at Google.
Thanks for coming, Nick. First of all, can you show us a demo of the app?
Sure. So if we start here on the overview page that you'll see when you open the app, you have key values for particularly important time spans with deltas against appropriate comparisons. Tap one of these, you can go through, see other important metrics for the same time period, as well as a graph. Tapping the other metrics, you can see those displayed as well. If we put this in landscape, you can swipe again, and also hold a single, simulated in this case, finger down to examine a value, or two fingers if you want to compare two values. Mm-hmm. So if I go back to the side menu here, you can see we also have the majority of the reports from the AdSense homepage. So if I select one of these entirely at random and go with countries, here you can see a bar graph of your performance across different countries. Mm-hmm. And again, we can go into landscape to examine a value, or if you want to see this data as a pie chart, you can swipe this and get a nice transformation.
Wow.
Thank you. And yeah, here you can tap from the landscape to go through the same thing.
Great. Okay, so you're obviously using the AdSense Management API, but are you using the Google Client Libraries for this?
Yes, I'm using the Google Client Library for Objective-C for all of the requests.
Okay, and I know you, for each page, you just use one request, or you just make one request.
Yes,
how do you do that?
Well, actually, if we go back to the overview here, mm-hmm. What you could do is you could request this entire time span as individual days and then add all the numbers together. But you don't want to do that because you can suffer rounding errors. The API will only return you with accuracy down to the cent, or down to the penny in this case. Mm-hmm. So you want to use the total of each report for each one of these values. So that's a total of 8 values. What we do is we collect all these together into a batch, mm-hmm. which allows us to basically take a list of requests and get a list of responses back. Mm-hmm. Objective-C Client Library has support for several different kinds of callbacks. In Objective-C, you can use something called a block, which is essentially a closure. So for every single value that comes back, our callback gets called, updates the data, and then the batch query has a nice feature where you can set an additional block to be called right at the end, which then updates the display.
Great. Are you also using the cache layer?
Yes. Another benefit of using a JSON API is that each request and response is essentially a string. Mm-hmm. So a very simple key value cache.
You're actually storing the response?
Yes.
Okay. That's cool. All right. So when developers start coding for the management API, for any APIs at Google, they have to register their project first. For iOS, what are the options? Because you have install application, web application.
Obviously, web application and a service account are not an option.
Yeah,
you have to go with an installed application. Just a regular other installed application will work just fine, but for extra security, you can use the iOS specific option that's available there as well.
Okay, great. And what about performance? Do you have to do anything special to improve it?
Batching is the main thing. Mm-hmm. That improved performance and means you don't have to worry so much about synchronization.
Okay.
And happily, just about everything else we need is provided by the client library, by core animation in iOS itself, and an excellent open source library called NimbusKit, which we use.
Okay, that's great. Okay, thank you very much for your time, Nick, and congrats on an awesome job.
Thank you very much.
Okay, see you later.